when you think about health in general of a community, you think about access to parks, you know, access to places where you can exercise, where you can walk freely. City Heights is a very underserved community. There isn't that much park space for the current population here. There usually isn't a safe place for young people to go.
Ever since I was 13, I skated. We're profiled as bad people. We're profiled as those that don't really know what's happening in our communities, and we cause harm to our community. We were harassed by police officers. We get ticketed for skating on curbs. But in reality, we just have nowhere else to go. It's because we don't have a skate park that's accessible here in our community.
Skateboards are loud. They look dangerous. They worry business owners. And there are laws about not skating in the street. But we are the center of the universe when it comes to skateboarding. This is who we are. This is part of our essence. I grew up in North County, and I watched a lot of skateboarders get marginalized. We were trying to do something, and we weren't able to articulate really the feelings that we know now. But we were trying to do something that we really thought was all right. And we would get in trouble for being places. And we didn't understand that. So it's very easy for a young person in that period of life and development to feel like the world's against us, the rules are against us.
Mid-City CAN stands for the Mid-City Community Advocacy Network. We're 26 years old. We've always worked in City Heights, and that's our primary focus. Mid-City CAN has facilitated the Mid-City CAN Youth Council for about 5 years. About 2 years in, the kids were looking for a project.
One of our youth council members got hit by a car while skateboarding, and that really showcased how unsafe our community was, especially for the skateboarding community. And so we decided to start a campaign on bringing a skate park here to City Heights.
They began talking to politicians, decision makers, and very few people took them seriously. Their youthfulness was being used as an excuse to not listen.
They kind of dismissed us, saying, yes, you guys want a park, but we have other things that are more important than just a skate park. So we went back to the community, we petitioned, we built a small army.
We began by being a small group of kids rallying around their friend to hundreds of community members. We were having rallies with 300, 400 people.
These kids are really dedicated. They educated themselves every step of the way throughout this entire process. They knew the end result that they wanted to get out of this, but they hadn't previously worked with the city, and so there are lots of challenges that came up through the process.
There was a lot of resistance from the community. They really, really didn't want a skate park here in City Heights. And I believe it was because there was a lot of misconceptions around skaters and the whole skating community. We found ourselves that we didn't have any hard data to back our stories up.
A ways into the campaign, the California Endowment, who's one of our largest donors, connected us to Human Impact Partners. And they came to us and said, hey, we have this thing called a health impact assessment, and we really think it can help your campaign.
A health impact assessment brings data to decision-making processes and informs decision makers and other stakeholders about how a proposed policy will impact health and equity. We also use it to support community-led campaigns around policy change to improve health outcomes.
So they came to us and they told us what this research was gonna do and how it was gonna help us. So we decided to partner with them.
Human Impact Partners led the HIA process. We managed the whole thing, but we did that with joint decision-making with Mid-City CAN's Youth Council.
Everything that was decided in the health impact assessment, the four key components to it, which is the general, the youth development, the crime rate, and as well as injuries, were all decided by the youth. The canvassing, going out, door knocking, finding out the precincts and talking to the people, these were all youth-led.
What the HIA really did was help us have a focus and a means for communicating our values around equity to decision makers. It was also instrumental in dispelling a lot of myths. The HIA said that people who skate are healthier, they're less obese. This is really good for the community. This is really important. The naysayers don't really understand what skating is and how good it is for the community.
We found having a skate park actually reduces injuries from skateboarding because it means that kids aren't skateboarding on the streets and you know, having to deal with cars and other vehicles or pedestrians.
And I do remember one night in particular, a meeting that was attended by a lot of adults, a lot of neighbors, and they became very difficult. And it was one of the young people from the Mid-City CAN Youth Council who quietly raised her hand, got up in the back of the room and said, I think a lot of you don't understand what this is. We've done the research, we have the data, and pointed them to the HIA, and it was really a great moment.
So at one point in the process, there may have been a 50-50 split between those who wanted the skate park and those who didn't. By the end of that meeting, once we worked through and educated the community, talked about the health impact assessment, the benefits of this project, we probably had a 90% favorable rating.
It took 5 years. For a young person, that's a really long time. But now that I'm here and physically standing next to the Skate Plaza, I feel like all that work was worth a while because now young people have a place to skate.
This is a great example of getting a project done. It was a great opportunity for the city to bring resources to work closely with this community. The youth were able to step up and become leaders. Their legacy in this community is going to be the impact that this park will have on the future youth of this community.
Being involved in this process, being able to use something I love to do, and being able to make that change here in the community that's sustainable, it helped show that no matter how young you are, your voice is heard.
I have to say that I really love watching the young people when they do what I used to do, when they do their problem solving, when they challenge themselves. The skate park is really a medium for a social transformation. It helps young people to understand and believe that the system and even their local government is here for them. It's not against them, but when they engage, they can get results.
A piece of advice that I would give a young person trying to make a change or a difference is to focus on something that they're passionate about and to just stay committed and continue working for it, because there is going to be a lot of no's. There is going to be a lot of people who say you can't do that and that you don't have a voice, but you do. They're wrong.